Hey guys, it's Danny. Today I'm giving you some fresh new leaks and rumors that we have on the new MacBooks and WWDC. I'm going to be giving you all the last minute leaks and rumors that we're expected for what we're expecting to see at WWDC. So it's going to be a fun day. I'm going to give you the new leaks on the MacBooks, iPad, iOS, and iPadOS, macOS 12, the future of that, hopefully the rumors and speculation. So it's going to be a fun day, so let's get right into the rumors. Okay, so first off, the thing that's been leaked probably the most out of all of these rumors I'm going to be showing you today, the most leaked one is definitely the new MacBooks. We're expecting to see Apple launching new MacBooks tomorrow. I'm filming this by June 6th. We're expecting to see new MacBooks by tomorrow. So it's going to have a radical new redesign. Have you seen all the renders? They look pretty sick. Have you seen the renders? They look awesome. And there's also rumors about like a MacBook Air with white bezels. If you've seen that video, you haven't maybe, but still, we're expecting to see that. We're not expecting, but there's rumors MacBook Air maybe. Wait, I don't know what it's going to be called, but the main focus is the MacBook Pros, the new MacBook Pros. So we're expecting to see them with more ports. When I mean more ports, I'm not talking about full-size USB, gigabit, no. We're just talking about just like the most basic ports that Apple can offer. So we're talking about with MagSafe, it's gonna be back. There's been weird renders of it being like a USB. We don't know USB-C. It's gonna have HDMI, full size HDMI, which is actually pretty good for professionals who have like your camera. So it's HDMI. You can plug it into your MacBook and you can just see there. And it also might charge the camera. That's actually a pretty cool feature if they can get that happening. And HDMI and SD card slot, which is actually it is really good because you don't have to have all those extenders. Those adapters, those things get lost and they get ruined all the time. So if I just have one inside your computer. And if you've actually seen the thickness of an Apple laptop, I actually have one. My dad has one for his work. You can actually see it. It's not that big. If you fit an SD card slot, you can easily fit it in the MacBook Pro and even in the MacBook Air. So I don't know why Apple does that. They want to make it look more like a clean design. But here, let me just bring it. Let me just show you guys how Apple could actually fit it. It's just, they can actually fit that thing. Okay, so here is the MacBook. This thing is really, it's like this big. You can, an SD card slot is not even like the USB-C port. It's really like two-thirds of it. You can easily fit a full-size SD card slot in this Mac. Apple can definitely do it, they're just not choosing to. But you can, this thing, you can definitely do it. Apple should do it. I'm hoping they do it, because they can definitely do it. It's not like they're not gonna do it, they should do it. That would be awesome. And then there's gonna be a touch bar because I kind of like the touch bar on this MacBook. It's really nice. It's really cool. You have other features there. It's really cool. Hopefully they can do that. That'll be awesome. But I mean, I'm not sure they'll do that. Hopefully they give it an option with touch bar or without. I'm going with the touch bar. And then Apple working on 10 core M1X chips, as you probably already heard. But it's gonna have 16 and 32 GPU core options, 32 in the high end and 16 for the baseline. 16 cores for the baseline, that's pretty good. I don't know if you're doing like 8K Red RAW. I don't know, 8K ProBus, I don't know what you're doing. Maybe you can go for 32, that's gonna be way too overkill. And 16, it's gonna be actually pretty. It's gonna be like baseline, that's gonna be way more than enough for doing 4K, R5, or Sony, or whatever. For 4K, 16 should be more than enough. 8K, then 32 GPU, I don't know, up to you. And then for the RAM, it'll have a ridiculous 64 gigabytes of RAM for the M1X. That's for Apple's unified RAM. If you've seen how good Apple's unified RAM has, if you have an iPhone, you know how good the RAM is. Good management of the RAM. Now just imagine 64 gigs on a laptop. That's gonna be overkill for video editing and doing lots of things at once. That's gonna be way good. So that's about all the rumors we have. That's all the speculation we have. Hopefully those things come true. That would be awesome if it does. Hopefully it does. I'm hoping we can get that. That'll be just amazingly good. The MacBook features looking bright. Now to iOS and iPadOS 15 rumors. So we don't really know that much. It's been a kind of quiet year for iOS and iPadOS 15 rumors. But here's what we do know. Users can put default response messages in the on the iMessage settings. So let's see, and let's say you have iMessages, let's say if you're driving and somebody says, hey, you want text, you can say, while driving, and when you have the steer button, you can automatically send a text that says, sorry, I can't, I'm driving. Or you can do whatever phrase you want. which is actually pretty good if you're driving in one text and drive at the same time. Do not do that, you're gonna crash probably. Your mind goes focused on your phone, do not do that. So that's a good feature Apple has added to prevent crashes. Now, and new messaging updates. So it's gonna be competing with WhatsApp, and like, you know, those that app that everybody has when they don't have an iPhone. WhatsApp's gonna compete with that. It's gonna be actually pretty cool. What I'm thinking they might do to WhatsApp, like, you know, like WhatsApp is made for like wallpapers for whoever you're texting. That's actually pretty cool. So you have a photo of that friend, you can put it as your wallpaper. And that's gonna be pretty cool. That's gonna be only for your side, and it's not gonna show up on their screen. But it's gonna be for like, that's gonna be really nice if you can actually do that. And there's gonna be Apple coming out full out on privacy, as you probably heard already. They're gonna go full out on privacy, and it's gonna be more privacy features. It's gonna be really good. And for new excessive touch, it's gonna be weird. We're not really sure what's gonna happen, but it's gonna be excessive touch, or whatever how it's called, for accessibility settings, all that stuff, more for like, you know, the handicapped and all that. It's gonna be pretty good there if you take advantage of voiceover. It's gonna have new features. We're not really sure what's gonna be, but we have that already. And there's also a food tracking feature maybe coming to the health app. We're not really sure about it. Hopefully it does, because that's gonna be pretty cool. Not clear if it's gonna happen. There's maybe rumors. We're not clear if it's gonna happen. Hopefully it is. Apple may have some tweaks to the iPhone and the iPadOS dark mode. You see, I personally had dark mode all the time. It looks super dope. It might have like minor features and changes, minor tweaks, but it doesn't how dark you want it, how light you want it. That's actually like a slider for exposure and for white and for like the white mode and, you know, just the regular mode or for dark mode. That's gonna be really cool. Now for macOS, we even know less about macOS 12 or whatever it's gonna be called. But still, this has not been a really good year for the WWDC rumors. Hopefully we can get some good leaks. Hopefully Apple has some pretty good features for macOS 12. We're not really sure what it's gonna be called. Their most favorable name is gonna be Monterey, Big Sur, Monterey. It just sounds about right in Apple naming schemes. Just sounds about right. I'm pretty sure it's gonna go Monterey. And we're not really sure what's gonna be. Not even sure what's gonna happen, but hopefully it has new design changes. That's gonna be actually pretty cool if they have like, I'm not sure they're gonna change like the Big Sur or icons. Hopefully they change it. Hopefully they have it just like Big Sur. No, of that stuff. But maybe I'm tweaking the settings, the search tab, all that stuff. Minor tweaks and changes, and major changes coming to Safari and other Apple apps. So it's gonna be pretty good. Now for WatchOS, we even know less. We're just gonna have some minor tweaks and changes for the settings, the messages, maybe the layout. I don't know, maybe. But we don't even know less. And HomeOS, even less. We don't even know that much. It's gonna be minor tweaks and changes. It's gonna be like an S update. Like iPad, it could be called HomeOS, HomeOS 14S version. It's not gonna be that much of it. It's not gonna be a huge update like iPadOS 14 or iOS 14, 13, and macOS Big Sur or so. So we can the veggie side. And yeah, that's about it. That's all the rumors I have. Hopefully you guys like the rumor series. The last MacBook Pro rumors I did blew up. I had 100 views. I'm really happy about that. Sorry about the audio. It wasn't really that good. I thought I had it connected right. Sorry about that. But still, I'm going to try making new more leaks rumors. If you haven't seen my latest video, you should check it out with the eye. Go up there or it'll be down. Or you can just check out my channel. I have a new video on the LG Arista 3 phone review from LG. Yeah, that's about it. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you in the next video.